The completion of the Human Genome Project lays a foundation for systematically studying the human genome from evolutionary history to precision medicine against diseases. With the explosive growth of biological data, there is an increasing number of biological databases that have been developed in aid of human-related research. In this lecture, we will present a brief overview of the major human-related biological databases. How the data is being arranged and classified into different categories according to their data types. And how to retrieve and analyze them. As human-related databases continue to grow not only in count, but also in volume, challenges are ahead in big data storage, processing, exchange, and curation. What is a database? A database is a collection of information that is organized so that it can be easily accessed, managed, and updated. Databases are composed of computer hardware and software for data management. The chief objective of the development of a database is to organize data in a set of structured records to enable easy retrieval of information. Although data retrieval is the main purpose of all databases, biological databases often have a higher level of requirement, known as knowledge discovery, which refers to the identification of connections between pieces of information that were not known when the information was first entered. For example, databases containing raw sequence information can perform extra computational tasks to identify sequence homology or conserved motifs. These features facilitate the discovery of new biological insights from raw data. According to a report of 2014 Molecular Biology Database Collection in the journal Nucleic Acids Research, there are a sum of 1,552 databases that are publicly accessible online. This does not include online services without publication in peer-reviewed journal or being developed by commercial companies. Thus, the actual number of online databases could well exceed this number. Considering the continuously proliferating number of biological databases, it becomes increasingly daunting and time-consuming to navigate in the huge volume of databases of interest. Considering the heterogeneity in data type, scope, and curation, biological databases can be classified into multiple categories under different criteria. According to the scope of data coverage, biological databases can be classified as comprehensive and specialized databases. Comprehensive databases cover different types of data from numerous species, and typical examples are GenBank, European Molecular Biology Laboratory, EMBL, and DNA Data Bank of Japan, DDBJ. These three databases were established as the International Nucleotide Sequence Database Collaboration in 1988 to collect and disseminate DNA and RNA sequences. On the other hand, specialized databases contain specific types of data or data from specific organisms. For example, WormBase is for nematode biology and genomics, and RiceWiki is for community curation of rice genes. According to the level of data curation, biological databases can roughly fall into primary and secondary or derivative databases. Primary databases contain raw data as archival repository, such as the NCBI Sequence Red Archive, whereas secondary or derivative databases contain curated information as added value, such as the NCBI RefSec. As a consequence of the explosive growth of data, curation increasingly requires collective intelligence for collaborative data integration and annotation. Therefore, biological databases can also be classified as expert-curated databases, such as RefSec, and community-curated databases, which are curated in a collective and collaborative manner by a number of researchers, such as GeneWiki. Finally, according to the types of data managed in different databases, biological databases can roughly fall into the following categories: DNA, RNA, protein, expression, pathway, disease, nomenclature, literature, and ontology. Despite having highly different functions, almost all biological databases shared similar architectural. Each consists of three tiers of software. At the bottom is a database management system, or DBMS, that manages a collection of facts. At the top is the web browser that transmits requests for data to the database and renders the responses as web pages. In the middle is a software layer that mediates between the DBMS and the web browser to turn data requests into database queries and to transform the query responses into hypertext markup language, or HTML. In addition to the gene database and PDB, there are many more biological databases designed for different purposes. The table here shows some of the most commonly used databases in bioinformatics that might help you in your research.